Hey, high levelers, welcome back to my channel. Here in this video, what I want to show you is how you can customize the high level menu option for particular users when they log in. Now, I've seen this question pop up in the high level Facebook group a whole lot as far as, you know, how do we hide menus or how do we prevent people from getting to this area? Well, that's the topic of this video. But before we continue, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please hook a brother up, click subscribe. I'm always looking to grow this channel and I always appreciate your support. So, alrighty, let's hop into it here. So, here we have a demo account inside of Highlevel. Now, typically, there's a couple of different ways you can attack this. I'm gonna go over the easiest way because I'm not a person that likes to work that hard. That sounds bad, but I don't want to work harder than I need to. Let me put it like that. So here's what I'm trying to show you is you could sit back and set up user accounts to specifically have access to certain things inside of Highlevel. Now, there are some people that said you can use some of the Highlevel customization tools, which are available. There's several, there's things you can buy. There's other like CSS customization tools. And inside of those tools, they can hide certain menu options forever from people because there's a certain code that runs and just hides through CSS, any of the menus and things like that. You can do that. I don't personally like doing that because I don't like doing it. I'm just gonna say it like that. But there are ways. This video is not going to show you how to do that. Now, I'm going to show you how you can use just the user level permissions inside of Highlevel to go in ahead and customize what people can get access to and what they can't. Now, before I do that, if you don't know about this little quick trip, I want to show you a little trick that you can use to flip back and forth between as an agency admin and then logging in as a particular user so you can simply quickly test this very quickly and easily inside of Highlevel. So if you don't know, up in the top right, I'm going to blow this up a little bit here. Give me a second. So in the top right, if you click on this, you get login as, and then if you click on this, you get a list of all the users that are in your account. Now, of course, you're going to have to pick the user account associated with your sub account. Now, let me explain that real quick, because if not, you will run across a security problem and Highlevel will freeze up on you. So first of all, go into the sub account first. You as an agency admin. So I'm in a demo account. This is just called Digi Global Agency, but I'm inside of my demo account. Now what I want to do is log in, do this login as function as a user inside of that account. So if you wanted to find out who this is, you can simply click on the business staff and look at staff, and there's of course nobody here. So let me go ahead and switch here. I guess bad example. I'm gonna do my other demo account where I've got a couple of different people here. So here we have Jane Smith and John Smith. Obviously they're just fake users, but right now we're gonna go ahead and customize these people inside of this particular sub account. So what we're gonna do is first I'm gonna click on the login as, and then I'm gonna log in as this Jane Smith user. It's gonna take a minute, and then Highlevel is gonna show you what the dashboard looks like as that particular user. So if you don't know this little trick, it's very helpful. If you're an agency admin and you wanna see or troubleshoot something at a user level, you don't have to log out and deal with cookies and log back in or use incognito windows and all these other kinds of complicated things. You can simply just use a login as function. Now, if you do this, I'm gonna show you real quick. It says logged in as Jane Smith, switch to my account. So if you click this link right here, it will switch you back to an agency admin. So we'll do that in just a minute. But I just wanted to show you, you log in as Jane Smith. Jane has access to all of this information that you see over here. Okay, normal account. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna switch back to the agency admin. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go in and customize Jane's account to limit what she could see. So inside of here, we're gonna click on My Staff. We're gonna open up Jane. Okay. There we go, just took it a minute. Now we're gonna come under user permissions. Now, if you don't know, I have a whole other video on my channel regarding user account setup and configuration that kind of goes over some of this, but look at it if you want a really detailed information about how to set up a user account. But here, let's just say that when we log in, we don't want this person to have access to campaigns. No on triggers, no on opportunities. We don't even want them to have access to the contact list, to the online listings, settings options, tags. We don't want them to have access to any of this stuff. Now, we are going to give them access to the funnel and the websites because let's just say Jane's going to be a website builder. But we don't need this. They don't need call reporting, agent reporting, social planner, workflows, payments, invoicing, affiliate manager, blogging, content AI. None of this stuff that's in here. We're turning all this stuff off. Facebook reporting. We're going to leave websites and the lead value. We're not going to give them that because we don't need to. They don't need to be in the opportunities or the anything like that. They're not dealing with appointments. We don't want them to do any kind of bulk requests here because that's like importing and exporting users. You know, you should be careful about that. Last thing you want to do is have somebody log into your account and have bulk request access to the contacts, and they download all of the contacts that you have in your database and sell them to your competitor. Not trying to put something into your mind, but stuff like that happens. So conversations, if they don't need to have access to the conversations, the review management, or even the memberships. So they have access to marketing, the funnels, and the websites. And let's just say we don't even want them to have dashboard stats. So we're really restricting this this particular user here. But when we do this, this user may have a very specific function. They come in and build funnels and build websites. They don't need to have access to the contacts. They don't need to have access to opportunities or, you know, any conversations that are happening with clients. They don't need any of that. So you can define what that person has just the way we did it. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the settings here to the main page, and we're going to log back in again as Jane Smith. So now we should see a completely different looking dashboard. Okay, so if we look here, we do have some information on the dashboard, but the main stats, the funnels, and everything else is gone. This conversations area, not sure. I guess they have access to maybe the templates or the triggers. So as you see, you can sit back and define this marketing. Oh, because we gave them access to the marketing area, that gave them access to this. So we can go back and remove that if we wanted to. Sites, notice they have access to funnels and some of the WordPress and forms and things like that. So that right there, we can simply click and just play with it. And just, you know, this is how you can test the account to see if they have access to everything. Now, once you build this once, you don't need to create it. I'm gonna go back into staff to Jane Smith, and I'm gonna turn off that marketing side of it. Give me a second here. This is just popping up to be a little bit slower here. So I'm gonna turn off this marketing side and just give them access to funnels and to websites. So here, when we come back, and I just wanted to go back again one more time and just try looking at this user. This is how you can go back and forth. And once you have a framework for this, this is something that you can actually do for your clients. And you could charge them for this, by the way, going through and doing an analysis of each one of their user roles. So if there's a salesperson role, what does that person have access to? What should they have access to? If they're a funnel builder or a website, what should they have access to? And being able to build documentation over what that particular type of user should have access to and what they shouldn't inside of Highlevel, so that when you do this, you can document this and then either do it for your client when they're creating new user accounts, or you can simply hand the document over to them and have them explain how to go through and set the users up every time. But notice in here, we see the menus have gone down. Here they have access to just the funnels, website, WordPress, client portal. So these are the things that you could see of how you can limit what people have access to. Now, this client portal, this is actually a custom menu link that's really not included by default. That's something that I have at my agency level, so that shouldn't be a part of it, but I can turn that off for this sub-account as well if I wanted to. But anyway, you see how using just the user permissions, you can easily go through and limit what somebody has access to. Now, you're not limiting what they can do by any means. They can notice they've got a new website function. If they go into funnels, they can build new ones. They can come here, click on this, and delete funnels. I mean, they can do all of that stuff inside of there, but they can't go to the CRM. They can't download the contacts. They can't take a look at opportunities. They can't build workflows or change the automations. Do you see what I mean? So this is the value of being able to limit what people can actually do and how you can limit the dashboard with just being very quick, very easy inside of Highlevel using the features that are already built in. So anyway, that's all I want to cover in this video. Just show you how to do that very quick and easily, how you can document it, potentially how you can make that a revenue source, or at least even an added bonus whenever you you create your accounts, that you could tell people, yes, we really restrict people's access to make sure they can only do what they're supposed to do. Because sometimes these people logging into the account aren't necessarily employees of the company. They could be virtual assistants. They could be 1099 contractors temporarily logging in to build a funnel. Well, if that's the case, do you really want to give a 1099 person access to your entire account, everything? I wouldn't. I would want to limit that person just so they can create the funnel. That's all, move out. And when that job is done, I probably would end up deleting that user account and getting rid of it. But I certainly don't want them to have access to everything in my account. So anyway, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, you know, leave me a like the video, please. It's always appreciated. And you know, YouTube always promotes those when you get a lot of likes. Leave me a comment if you have a question regarding this. If you did have any other questions regarding user account creation, please go on my channel and look at the user account configuration video that I have. That's a little bit more extensive. I really just kind of covered the menu options and being able to hide them in this particular video just to show you how you can do that. But anyway, thank you very much for visiting my channel and have a great day. Hey, if you're interested in learning more about Highlevel, click on the link below regarding my free Highlevel course. It goes over everything that you need to do to get your account created, get it set up, and get it going in about 2 days. I also, if you sign up with Highlevel with me, I do offer a snapshot as well as a client onboarding course that can be used by your client or even used to train your own team to do client onboarding. I want to thank you so much again and have a great day.